let's expose more features hidden in the envelopes. There's still a lot more. Hi. In the menu of the envelope, there are a bunch of tools available. For automation clips, you find them here in the little menu or under the wrench tool. Let's say you created a little pattern and want to loop it. Instead of going into the points themselves and set them to loop start and loop end, there's a tool which does it in one action. Flip the envelope vertically or scale the levels via multiply, offset or center with tension. Normalize levels. The step editing mode allows you to freehand draw your envelope. Freehand drawing creates often more points than really needed. Decimate points is a great help here. Decimate points can on the other side cause some too straight lines and sharp edges. If you like to smooth this a bit more, the filter tool is a good friend. Or for those who like it a bit different, smooth up. If you've got uneven spikes in your envelope and you like to center them, there's the next tool for you. Turn all points smooth changes the curve type for all points to the smooth type. Single curve is the default, and this action turned them all to smooth. Create sequence we skip for the moment. Last but not least, there is an option to analyze audio files and create envelope shapes out of them. For example, a drum loop. The envelope now tries to follow the waveform of the audio file. This action creates a ton of envelope points too, so sometimes decimating them can be a good idea. If you make changes to the envelope, sometimes one could wish afterwards to undo them. Ctrl-Z doesn't work. But the menu offers an undo function, including a little history of the last 20 changes. Here are two important modifiers when working with envelopes. Shift left click and move a point locks the movement vertically. Means whatever I do, the point just moves horizontally. Perfect if you like to put a point to a different place without changing its value. This is especially handy when working with automation clips. It's nearly impossible to move a point to the side without changing its value. Shift-click-drag is the solution here. Ctrl-click and drag locks the envelope point horizontally. As long as Ctrl is held, it's impossible to change the horizontal position. Very handy for changing values without accidentally moving the point's place. The last part I like to show for today is how simple you can create sample and hold-like shapes for some controlled randomness. We have seen before how easy it is to draw in your own shapes with the pencil tool. Now watch what happens with snap to grid enabled and holding shift while clicking or drawing. You can easily change points afterwards by still holding Shift. Such sample and hold modulations are often interesting for filter movements with higher resonance settings. To bring the part slowly together, let's save our envelope so far, as I like how it sounds and want to have it stored to be able to go back if I break it. Navigating to my user library envelope folder and give it a name. Now I am free to try some variations. But to be honest, I like better how it was before. That's all for today. I hope these videos motivate you to dive a bit deeper into this topic. You will not regret it. Modulations are the salt in the soup for every sound design, and ImageLine gave us some very powerful tools for the journey. Have fun, and thank you for watching.